Now, I have had my Steam Deck for about, let's say, 4 months now. I think that's around the time frame. And I have seen tons of videos. 10 best tips for your Steam Deck. 10 things to do with your Steam Deck. And all of them have been absolutely useless. Now, when I say that, I don't mean to bash the creators. It's really not their fault. They're giving you very basic beginner tips. But here, in today's video, we're gonna go from beginner to advanced. So if you really wanna take advantage of what you have in your hands with your Steam Deck, this is the video for you. Let's get started. So here we are in the library of my Steam Deck. And the first tip I wanna give everybody is you see this set of filters and the verified playable, untested, and not supported games that you can filter by. I want you to completely ignore every single thing that is shown here, whether it's verified and playable, untested or unplayable. These icons and these metrics do not mean what they say they mean. And I know you're thinking to yourself, but Alex, Valve is doing testing on these things. Why wouldn't they be there? Well, the thing is simple. Games that are unsupported and unplayable actually run just fine. And I'll show you that example right now. Now, games that are also verified only or verified as playable sometimes don't even work correctly and have a very poor frame rate target. So look, just because it shows unsupported or unplayable doesn't mean you cannot play it on your Steam Deck. But let me show you guys a live example of a game that is completely unsupported, but in fact actually works. And this is Sniper Elite 5. Now, the game is in fact literally listed as unsupported. It does not run. It cannot run on this Steam Deck, right? They're still adding support for the game. Well, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna show you guys. We're gonna go into properties, compatibility. I'm not forcing a Proton layer. We're gonna go ahead and launch it. We're gonna see what happens. Now, do you wanna know why this game was listed as unsupported? It's because the multiplayer component of Sniper Elite 5 requires easy anti-cheat. If we're not gonna play multiplayer, I'm just gonna say no. Why would I waste my time with something I'm not even ever gonna use? And then here we are. Here is Sniper Elite 5 running at around 60 FPS. Not totally stable, but I can make it that way with some extra tweaking. Running on a quote unquote unsupported game. Now, multiplayer is the only reason why this game is unsupported because of easy anti-cheat. Now, if I don't wanna use multiplayer, I don't wanna play anything with anti-cheat, then why wouldn't the game just run? So that's rule number one. Just because it says unsupported, unverified, or even playable doesn't mean that is gospel and you shouldn't follow that to the letter. Try it out yourself and see what happens. Now we're gonna go into the real gritty stuff here about the Steam Deck. Let's jump into desktop mode. And if you don't know how to get there, either hit the power button or the Steam button and go to power. You'll see switch to desktop mode, it'll be there. And the first thing we're gonna do is head over to Dolphin. This is tip number two. This is all about your file management. Now, the one thing I really wanna stress is that if you're gonna be doing any sort of emulation, adding non-Steam games, playing games from GOG or Epic or things like that, the first thing you wanna head over and do is go to the file manager. This little folder down here is called Dolphin. And then when you have that open, this little hamburger bad boy right here, you wanna click that and click show hidden files. See, when I remove that, you just got this here. It seems very basic and simple. But when you show hidden files, that's what you want because this .local file is where all your games from Steam are stored. So if you have a save file that's missing, if you have mods you wanna add, if you wanna find what the actual folders are for the actual games you're installing, they're all in this .local file under share, and then you go right into Steam and you're gonna go jump into Steam apps, go into common, and there are all your games. Pretty wild, huh? You're not gonna be able to see that if you don't show the hidden files. Now, what's really also cool is that if you don't wanna go through all of that, you can take the local folder and just put it right there to the left. You can even do that with the Steam folder or anything else like that. And if you download any flat packs, they're under .var, and you go to app, and they're all right here. So you know where all your flat packs are too. Now, speaking of flat packs, let's go into the Discovery Store for tip number three. Tip number three is really simple. If you ever download a flat pack, my suggestion is every so often, open in desktop mode, open the Discovery Store, and update all your apps. It's incredibly important because there's a lot of stuff that actually gets updated, and even if you're doing things like emulation or open source ports, you wanna make sure they stay updated and you're good to go. So that's a really big thing to be aware of. Now, my next tip is gonna be installing the flat pack of disk Usage Analyzer. This, in my opinion, is one of the best things people do not use for some incredible reason. It's honestly wild to me because this will give you access to every folder, subfolder, directory, and every single file location inside of your Steam Deck. Whether you install something you didn't mean to, or you added something you didn't need to, or you want to just delete things, or you want to go through and find out what's actually there, this is how you do it. It even gives you a great ring to show you exactly what you have in terms of space and what is taking up space in your Steam Deck. You can even go ahead and open this up and you can see exactly what's going on. So as you can see, the Steam Apps folder is 300 gigs. All my compatibility tools are 1.2. I have Ubuntu in here. I have other things as well. So if I go to Steam Apps and I have common and comp data. So you're looking like, what's comp data? Well, I also have all these other games that are installed in here. Comp data can be things like save files. It could be non-Steam games. It could be all kinds of things that you have on file in order for you to go ahead and just move over through and actually have games on your system. They don't have to be Steam games or anything like that, but you can actually see what file is where, the file size, and even what's happening in terms of a visual representation of what is inside of each folder. This is imperative because if you install something by mistake or you can't find something, this is where you go to find that specific file or folder. And it's a great tool and resource. Like I said, if you're going to be emulating, installing non-Steam games, all that kind of stuff, this is incredibly useful. My next tip is going to be to install the flat pack of Proton UpQt or PUBGUI. This is so amazing because this is the one thing that is going to save you when Valve has not updated their Proton version. Now, here's the cool thing about this. When you're inside of Proton UpQt, you also want to install what's called Luxtrapeta. Now, Luxtrapeta is going to be used for other types of games that just can't run on Proton, and it'll give you that list of games there. If you also want to play games like Morrowind with OpenMW, it'll install all the open source versions of those games into your Steam Deck, and you can just run it one time and not have to find those open source versions yourself. So it's really, really good if you want to play a lot of older games on Steam that aren't directly supported, that don't run on Proton, Luxtrapeta is going to be the way to go. Now, you always want to check to make sure if you have an updated version. So what we'll do is we'll just go ahead and just update it real quick and see. So we'll just add version so I can just run it through with you guys. So GE Proton 737 is the newest one. The one I have right now is 35. So we're going to install that. Now, as you can see, it's downloading right now. And once that's done, I will have that compatibility layer of 7-37 for Proton inside of my properties. And I can use that if the version of Proton Steam naturally has does not work for whatever reason. This version will always be ahead of what Steam has because they have to double check and they have to verify to make sure it's going to be more capable, or I guess more stable. But these versions are already stable. They just got to make sure it runs on the Steam Deck well. And guess what? They already do. So we can bypass whatever Valve wants to put out, and we can just install our own. Same thing with Luxtrapeta. The way you do that is you go to add version, and instead of GE Proton, Luxtrapeta, and then you add that. Just like when you want to go ahead and check every so often for the flat pack updates that you have in your discovery store, you want to check Proton UpQt to make sure you have the newest version of either Proton or Luxtrapeta updated in your system. Now, the next tip I want to give you is I've had a lot of people say, hey, Alex, how do I install GOG games? How do I install the Epic Games Launcher? How do I play Fortnite? How do I do these other things? What you want to install next is called Lutris, and it is in the Discovery Store, and I've already got it uploaded here. In fact, I have gotten quite a few games to work. The only one I haven't gotten to work yet is Icewind Dale 2, but out of all my GOG games and even Blizzard games, I have Diablo 3 working, I have Diablo 2 Resurrected working, even the original Diablo 2 working, Legacy of Kain, all these classic old games are working. And if I want to install them, I absolutely can by connecting my GOG library, my Epic account, which I don't have, an Origin account, a Ubisoft account, and even your own Steam account that you can add here as well. What's great about this is that if you have a game that requires Windows for whatever reason, and it won't run off of the Force Proton in the Steam, it won't run off Proton UpQt, and it requires some sort of Windows dependency, you can actually go ahead and install it through Lutris into Steam and have it run through Wine. And in fact, the great thing about this is if you go to the website and you just pick the game you want to play and just punch it in. So if we want to do, let's say, Morrowind, for whatever reason, we can go ahead and pick Morrowind Game of the Year Edition. We can scroll down, and with Lutris open, we can choose the different versions of Lutris we want to have installed of Morrowind, whether it's the GOG version, the Steam version, or the Steam Proton version. And you can choose which one, and Lutris will automatically install all the Wine dependencies. It'll install everything that you need and all the stuff from the Windows categories of what games you need in those files and put them into your Steam Deck, so you can just run the game through Steam directly. You can even make a Steam shortcut for it, or you can just add it to Steam. Lutris is honestly great once you figured out the little quirk, and that quirk is have Lutris open, go to the website, and then click install from the website. Don't try to install it from the actual flat pack. It's not gonna work. It won't install Wine. It'll crash on you. It's happened too many times already for me before. So that's that next step. The next tip I wanna give is really what's called open source ports. Many of your classic old games are either no longer in development or just don't work on Linux. And a lot of people, what they've done is they've gone around and they've actually created engines and made them open source and ported them to Linux, so older games can run natively on Linux with those open source ports. And that's really great because Devolution X is one of the best open source ports for Diablo 2. I know there's Beelzebub as well, but that's the one I like personally. And there's always gonna be an open source port of an old game, more than likely. And you'll find that, right? So if you go in the Discovery store, you'll see things like OpenMW, you'll see Mindtrust, you'll see all kinds of open source ports like Cave Story NX, Endless Sky. And I'm just scrolling through here directly, right? Just to see what's going on. And if you wanna see if a game has an open source port, you can just Google, hey, does this game have an open source port? Here's Open Red Alert. Here is literally Red Alert 1 as an open source port for Linux on your Steam Deck. There it is, it just works. And that's pretty much a super cool thing. And the best thing about the open source porting is the fact that we go into our next tip, and that is emulation. Emulation on the Steam Deck is honestly one of the best things you can possibly do. And if you want to get deeper into emulation, you can check out the playlist I have in the description down below, where I go over every single emulator on the Steam Deck and that's available to you to play, and how to install them one by one or all together at once with Emu Deck. Having decades of games available to you on your fingertips, on top of your Steam library, on top of everything else as well, is just truly phenomenal. Now, unfortunately, I can't just give you where to go ahead and get those ROMs. You should have them yourselves and then just dump those carts. But I think with a little Googling, you should be able to figure out where to go. You probably won't need me for that. Tip number 9, and it's one I think anyone can use, even if you don't have a Steam Deck, and that is SteamGridDB.com. This website gives you all kinds of custom artwork, backgrounds, logos, everything you can use to customize your games directly, either on your Steam Deck or in your Steam library directly on your PC. Now, here's something that I think is really cool, because I didn't like the Final Fantasy VII Remake artwork, and it was like pink and weird. Didn't really jive with me. Also, there are some not safe for work ones. You know, you can just do that if you want to. But this one I think is really cool. So it matches the original FF7 one, which is great. And you can just go ahead and just add that by simply opening up Steam directly on your Steam Deck and then just clicking that, hey, I want to go ahead and change this artwork. So here's Wonder Boy and the Dragon Trap. Left click it there, manage, set custom artwork. Find where you downloaded the actual file for the artwork. Say okay, and it's gonna change there directly. You can do that with everything. You can do it with the actual background right here, set custom background or logo, even adjust the position of the logo. It's awesome. You can make it what you wanna look like, and that way you can customize it to your own. There's even animated versions of those icons and backgrounds. So it looks really awesome, especially when you go ahead and you're in game mode of the Steam Deck and you're playing everything. It just looks cool. So give that a shot. And for my final tip, it has to do with SD cards directly. Now, the kind of SD card you get, yeah, people can talk about like, oh, this one's faster, this one's slower, whatever. That's not what I'm talking about today. If all you're going to be doing is file transfers or using an SD card to store ROMs, you don't have to format it for Linux. You can literally just format that SD card for Windows, copy all your ROMs over, slap it into your SD card slot into the Steam Deck, and it's going to be able to register and read all those ROMs and everything from that SD card without needing to be formatted again. The only time you want to format an SD card for the Steam Deck is if you're going to be installing games directly from Steam into that SD card. So if you have the $399 version of the Steam Deck, that's when you want to format that SD card for that. I've got a few of them already because I just wanted to have a terabyte of storage for my Steam Deck because I'm insane. But you can do that with anything that you want. So definitely be aware of that and don't be freaked out if you want to go ahead and try that either. Those are my best 10 tips for making your Steam Deck the best it can possibly be. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. Let me know what other things I could have added for, like, let's say a secondary video. And if you want to see more stuff as well, check out the emulation playlist that I have if you want to start emulating games on your Steam Deck. If you want to see more content like this, subscribe to the channel. We are crossing 32,000 subs and it's honestly insane. So thank you again very much. And if you want to see even more kinds of content, we have fanboy content, gaming news, PC port reviews, the whole shebang on the channel. So definitely check it out. If you want to join the Discord, you can do that by becoming a YouTube member, a Patreon supporter, or a Twitch sub. Just make sure everything is synced to the Discord and you'll be good to go. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one and I'll see you next time.